Hello everyone. Outseal PLC Nano only has 8 digital inputs, 8 digital outputs, and 2 analog inputs. But you can have more inputs and outputs in a single application by connecting more Outseal PLCs. Multiple Outseal PLCs can communicate through the I2C SDA, SCL, and GND pins with one master and several slave devices. The ladder program will reside in the master PLC, which will then access the IOs of the slave PLCs. The IOs on the extended modules will correspond to the variable bits on the master PLC as shown. To convert the Arduino Nano PLC to extended IO module, first, connect it to your computer USB port. Then go to the settings menu in Outseal Studio. Select Nano V5, the port number, and the baud rate. Click on the Tools tab and set the TWI slave address as required. In this case, it is left at 1. Then click on Compile plus Send to the Nano. If the upload is successful, the power, TX, and RX LEDs on the Nano will be steady on. The Nano can then operate as an extended I/O module. Now, set the extended I/O module connection with the master PLC, connecting their SDA, SCL, and GND pins. Connect an LM35 temperature sensor to A.1 of the extended I/O module. A push button switch to S.1 through the PC817 module, and an indicator lamp to ROTON through a relay module. The EDO and EDI instructions from the data instruction group retrieve the extended I/O module outputs and inputs values. The EDO will assign values to the 8 digital outputs ROTON to ROTON of the Nano through variables ROTON17 to ROTON24. Add an SPWM instruction to the ROM. Set its variable to P.1, the time base to 1000 milliseconds, on to 1, and off to 1. Insert a ROM and add a contact and a coil to it. Set the contact variable to P.1.st and the coil variable to ROTON17. Insert another ROM and add an EDO instruction to the ROM. Double click on it and set the type to Nano. Ensure that the slave address is 1 and the PLC memory is ROTON17. Then upload the code to the PLC and observe the flashing of the indicator lamp connected to ROTON of the extended I/O module. The EDI will read the 8 digital inputs S.1 to S.8 of the extended I/O module and assign their values to variables S.17 to S.24. It will also read the 2 analog inputs, A.1 and A.2, and assign their values to A.3 and A.4. Insert 3 rungs at the top of the program. Drag an EDI instruction to the first rung. Double-click on it and set the type to Nano. Ensure that the address is 1. Extra data is A.3 and PLC memory is S.17. Add a contact and a flip on rising instruction to the second room. Assign S.17 to the contact and B.1 to the flip on rising instruction. Drag a scale instruction to the third room. Set the input data to A.3. The input mean to 0. The input max to 307. The scale mean to 0. The scale max to 150. Offset to 0. And the result to I.1. Finally, add a contact before the SPWM with variable B.1. Then upload the code to the PLC and go to online mode. Observe the temperature value of I.1. Press the push button switch to start and stop the blinking of the indicator. And that is it. Thanks for watching. If this video is helpful, please leave a comment below. Do give a thumbs up and click on the subscribe button if you are yet to. See you in the next video.